Hello dear students, now I will discuss about shortest distance between two lines. So first of all, for that just remember the previous formula. Straight line can be written as like this: R equals to A plus lambda into B. Vector equation of a line. This is equation of line in vector form in 3D. Here line parallel to the vector B and passing through a point A whose position vector is A, and there is a vector B. Suppose this is vector B, so this line is parallel to this vector. This line is parallel to this vector. This is the equation of line. Here we know in Cartesian coordinate system also in and vector form, suppose A is a point and its coordinate is A, B, C. Then we can write, this is origin, then we can write its position vector as OA, just like A into I plus B into J plus C into K. Here remember that point having position vector, this means point having coordinate ABC. Also, if this is position vector, then its direction ratios are also given by ABC, because direction ratios are given by x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1. So here origin means what? 0, 0, 0. So A minus 0, B minus 0, C minus 0, A, B, C. So direction ratios of OA are what? A, B, C. So if we have a vector in component form, then the scalar components are direction ratios of that vector. That is, we are having this vector, that means its scalar components are direction ratios of this vector. And these two lines are parallel, so its direction ratios are also a scalar component of B. So direction ratios can be found from here. And we also know that it can be written in Cartesian coordinate system, just like, suppose A having position vector A, if A is given also in component form, then we can find scalar components that are the coordinate of this. Suppose its coordinate is x1, y1, z1. Then its direction ratios are A1, B1, C1. Direction ratios of B. Its direction ratios. Then Cartesian equations, how we write? Like this: x minus x1, y minus y1, z minus z1. The x1, y1, z1 are the coordinate of point. And in denominator, just write A1, B1, C1, direction ratios. So this is Cartesian form, this is vector form. Here R means arbitrary point on the line. Your x, y, z means arbitrary point on the line. This is Cartesian system, this is vector system. R means x, I, y, z, z k, sum. Okay. So, this is our basic idea. Now, for finding angle between two lines, suppose this is first line, A1, B1, C1, A1 is first vector, B1, this is first line, and second line is what? Second line is R equals to A2 plus mu B2. Two lines in vector form. Its coordinate, suppose x1, y1, z1. Its coordinate, x2, y2, z2. Its direction ratios, that means scalar component, vector component, we can write A1, B1, C1. This B1 and this B1, not confused with this, okay, like this. Its direction ratios A2, B2, C2. Then, this line is parallel to B1, this line is parallel to B2, that is B1, first line, L1, second line, L2. Because L1 is parallel to B1 and L2 is parallel to B2. L2 is parallel to B2. So these are, this is parallel to this, this is parallel to this. So angle between these two lines is also the angle between line. So angle between line, this angle and angle between line and angle between B1 B2. That is angle between B1 B2 are the angles between line. So cos theta equals to angle between B1 B2 means direction ratios, two line having direction ratios. Means we can write like this, B1 dot B2 upon mod B1 mod B2. Modulus means acute angle. So it can be solved. B1 dot B2 vector having direction, scalar component dot product, that is what? A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 by dot product. B1 means what? B1 means A1i plus A2j plus A3k. Similarly, B2 means what? Sorry. A1 B1 C1. Here A2i B2j C2 k. So dot product is this. Now modulus of their what? Root of A1 square, B1 square, C1 square. Same, A2 square, B2 square plus C2 square. So, this is cos theta equals to. Okay. And also, this formula can be written in sin theta form. Sin theta form like this. Sin theta equals to, from here we can get sin theta form notation. Just like how cos theta equals to sin theta equals to what? Sin theta equals to root of 1 minus cos square theta. By using this, we can write value of sin theta for about in terms of A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. So here, just this type of formula is given. Clear? Yes. A1 square plus B1 square plus C in a square, we can write in short, sum of A1 square means A1, B1, C1. A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square. Similarly, sum of A2 square means A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. Here, A, B, B, C, just like follow the formula, this square plus this square plus this square. A, B, B, C, C. That means A, B, B, C, B, C, C, A, CA, and here minus sign in between, and number 1 2 2 1 1 2 2 1 1 2 2 1, this is the formula for sin theta. So this formula, the angle between two lines are parallel to two vectors whose directional ratios are a1 b c and a2 b c. Okay, so this is our basic formula about angle between two lines. Clear? So here, now we have to discuss about shortest distance between two lines. Just know what is the distance between two lines. Distance between two lines means, we know in two dimensional plane, two lines either parallel or intersecting line. In two dimensional plane, we can draw line. If first line is this and second line may be like this or may be intersecting this. That is, in two dimensional plane, line may be intersecting or parallel. But in 3D space, there are some lines which are neither parallel nor intersecting. Just you can feel, this is room, and just we are connecting two points, these corner points and these corner points. In this plane, there will be a line. Okay, and also we can connect upper point to other corner point. They are connected. Maybe a line on the plane, but that line and this line never intersect and never will be parallel. So this type of line are known as skew line, which are not neither parallel nor intersecting. That is, this type of line are non-coplanar. That means two lines does not lie on same plane, because 3D space, a space means this blank space, okay. So here is a plane, this is a plane, here is a line, and maybe another plane also, upper plane. So there may be another line, so they are not coplanar. So neither parallel nor coplanar. That is, non-coplanar line, skew lines. Skew lines means they are not intersecting and not parallel. Okay, so that type of line, suppose there is a line and also there is a line. Now, non-coplanar, in the space, not in plane. In plane, they will intersect. But a space, there is a line, there is a line. They are not intersecting and not parallel. So, for finding distance between two lines, how can you find the distance between two lines? Perpendicular distance. There is a, suppose this is a point and this is a point. We can find distance between this line. But there is also shortest distance. There is a distance which will be short, smallest, that is shortest distance. The shortest distance is what? Just like this, this is a line, this is a point, and this is also distance from this point to this line, this is also distance, this is also distance, but perpendicular distance is the shortest distance. So for skew line, length should be perpendicular to both line, that is shortest distance. Here perpendicular also, here perpendicular also. Okay? So, L1, L2. Like, this is shortest distance. Shortest distance. Between shortest distance. Because, perpendicular to both the line. So now, suppose we are having two line, just like this, in vector form, R equals to vector A plus lambda vector. This first line, A1, B1, this first line, L1, and another line, A2 plus mu B2, where there is some constant for this first equation, this is second equation. Clear? Now we have to find shortest distance between these two lines. Just remember the formula. Okay? We can derive the formula, but you require only formula. So just see, shortest distance is equals to, this line is parallel to this vector, this line is parallel to this vector. This line is passing through this. So from, if we are having a line in a vector form, then we can compare with this and we can get A1, A2, B1, B2. Okay? So here, formula, shortest distance, just you have to write B1 vector cross B2 dot A2 minus A1. B1 cross B2, B1 cross B2, we can get value from equation of line. B1 cross B2 dot product. Here is cross product, here dot product. A2 minus A1, A2 minus A1. Upon modulus of B1 cross B2. Clear? So this is shortest distance formula. Just remember it. Okay? Shortest distance formula. If equations are given in vector form. So first of all, find B1, B2. Find their cross product. We know cross product is what? B1 cross B2 equals to mod I J K A1 B1 C1 A2 B2 C2. If they are what? Direction ratios of B1 and B2. That is a scalar component of from this vector. Just write and you can solve it. A vector and then that vector into A2 minus A1 is again a vector, take its dot product, we can get a scalar quantity and also find its modulus by taking modulus, and this is a scalar quantity, taking positive value, that is shortest distance between two lines, this is in vector form. Clear? This is vector form. Okay. Now, for finding shortest distance of Cartesian equation of, between two lines which are given in Cartesian equation. So, Cartesian equation we can write Cartesian equation just like this. Suppose this is vector form, shortest distance formula. This line can be written as Cartesian equation just like this. A1 means, suppose A1 means x1, y1, z1. Point. A1. A2 means x2, y2, z2. Okay? These are two points. Or this is B1 means having direction ratios A1. B1, C1, direction ratios. its direction ratios means scalar components is a to b to c to. Then how can we write this equation? Just x minus x1, y minus y1, z minus z1, and its scalar component a1, b1, c1, direction ratios of this vector. Just write a1, b1, c1. This is first equation. This can be written like this. Similar, this vector can be also written like this. X minus x2, a2, y minus y2, b2, z minus z2, c2. This is other Cartesian equation. And shortest distance between these two, just like this, shortest distance equals to formula. Just remember formula, okay? Very simple. You have to solve a determinant. You have to solve a determinant. In place of this, here in Cartesian form, there will be determinant. That is x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, z2 minus z1, here a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, a2, b2, c2, and here a, b, b, c, c. Here sum of a, b, a, b square, a1, b1, sum means what? Three terms. Sum, first short writing. That is, this is equals to what? AB, BC, CA minus square plus square minus plus minus square. It means this, three terms, just similar, AB, BC, CA. So AB, BC, CA. Here, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1. So this is the formula. So shortest distance between two Cartesian lines with Cartesian form. So this x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, passing point of this two line, a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are the direction ratios of that line. Just use this formula. Shorter distance. Okay. A1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are given. Just solve this determinant, a number divided by this, take modulus, means total, taking modulus sign, means positive value. Okay. This is shortest distance. Modulus. Shortest distance. This is Cartesian form. This is vector form. So remember it. Now, we will solve. And finding distance between two parallel lines. Two parallel lines means lines are parallel. Parallel line means distance between anywhere. Just perpendicular distance. This is shortest distance between parallel lines. If two lines are parallel, then their direction ratios are same. So a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2 are same. That means zero. This will be zero. Give zero. But not zero, because parallel line, distance between parallel line, there is distance, some distance, maybe this line, this line, this line, this line. So for getting distance, shortest distance between parallel lines, shortest distance between parallel line is equals to what? In this formula, just use, because for parallel line, this A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are same. That is, B1, B2 are same. For parallel line, you can write only B, B. Both are same. That is, B1 equals to B2. In this case, just write, suppose that is B. And here, only B. That is the formula. That is, modulus of vector B dot A2 minus A1 upon mod B vector. Parallel lines. Clear? So between parallel lines, B cross A2 minus A1 upon mod B. Clear? In vector form. You can write Cartesian form to vector form to Cartesian form, because vector form gives easy approach. So, there will be both vectors same. So, just use in place of here, only B. Here, only B. And this will give the shortest distance between two parallel lines. Okay? Now, we will solve the questions from 11.2. Remaining questions from 10. So here, find angle between lines which are given in vector form. In question 10, there are two set of lines. So, same type of questions I will solve in short. You have to write in detail in your copy. Okay? Because presentation, that is writing, should be very clear so that the examiner can understand, okay, in a very well manner. You have to write just like book. Okay, so here questions given, question 10, solution. Of 11.2. Okay. There is given, find angle between two pairs of lines. The lines are given in vector form. And first and second question. 11 questions, find the angle between the following pair of lines. They are the Cartesian form. So remember that one thing here important, that is, just like A 11.2, okay, question 10, just we use formula for question 10. There are two questions, 10-1, 10-2. Just I will solve one here in short. Given 2 minus 5 plus k. Given lines are, they are in vector form. So what? 2 minus 5 k. 2 minus 5k means r equals to 2i minus 5j plus k plus of constant is given lambda 3 to 6, lambda 3i plus 2j plus 6k, and another line r2 that is 7 minus 6 k, 7 minus 6 k, 7 I minus 6 k plus mu, different constants used for a straight line. Okay, here 1 2 2 means I plus 2 j plus 2 k. Similarly, second question is given also in other constants as a coefficient of vectors. So first question is this, very simple, we have to find the angle between these two lines. Angle between these two lines means, how can we get the value? We know, cos theta equals to what? A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 upon A1 plus A2 and B2 C2. Sum of A1 square, B1 square, C1 square. Root over A2 square, B2 square, C2 square. Here, this is vector B. This is vector B1, vector B2. This is A, vector A1, vector A2. Two lines. Just compare and write. Just you have to write in detail. Now, I am just only write the value. A1, B1, C1 means what? Here, 3, 2, 6. So, here, 3, 2, 6. And A2, B2, C2 are 1, 2, 2. So, 1, 2, 2. Just multiply, plus, multiply, plus. From this formula. Upon. Root over A1, B1, C1. A1 B1 C1 3 to 6 3 square 2 square 6 square root 1 square 2 square 2 square. So we can write 3 plus 4 plus 12 upon here 9 plus 4 13 plus 36. 13 plus 36, 49, here 9. So we can see that 9 upon 7 into 3, that is 3 by 7, take modulus sign. So, answer is what? Sorry, this is 19. This is 19. So, 19 by 21 cos theta equals to implies theta equals to cos inverse 19 by 21. Okay, 19 by 21. 19 by 21. So, this is the angle between two lines. Simple. Similarly, you can do second questions. Then, second of 10. Okay, now question 11, there are given what? Cartesian form. So here also two lines are given, two pairs of lines are given, and we have to find the angle between their lines. So question 11, first, what are the line? x minus 2, y minus 1, z plus 3. X minus 2, y minus... x minus 2, y minus 1, z plus 3. Y minus 1, z plus 3. Upon, equal. 2, 5 minus 3. And here, x plus 2 minus 1, first equation, x and these and these, two equations are given. X plus 1 upon minus 1 equals to x plus 2 upon minus 1, y minus 4 by 8, and z minus 5 by 4. This second equation. Okay. So you know from here also this is L1, this is L2. So direction, ratios of lines are what? We can see. These are the direction ratios. 2, 5 minus 3 and minus 1, 8, 4. Remember that when the equation are given in Cartesian form, in that case, just you have to write in standard form. That means coefficient of x should be 1. If there is writing like this, 2x minus 2 by 1, then you have to convert it as x with single, that is divide it by 2, then x minus 1 divided by 2. So we can write x minus 1 upon 1 by 2. So this will be a 1 if given in this form. But here is a standard form because one coefficient, and so on. Clear? So here, these are the direction ratios of line. Therefore, if theta is angle, then cos theta equals to, just you can use the formula. A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 upon root over summation A1 square, root over summation A2 square, means sum of squares, modulus. So we can use just like this. A1, A1, A2, C1, this. 2, 5 minus 3. 2, 5 minus 3 into A1, A2, C1. A2, B2, C2. Minus 1. 8, 4 upon sum of squares. So 2a square plus 5a square plus minus 3a square root. Same root. Minus 1 square, 8 square, 4 square. Just write the value, you can get solution. Okay, minus 2 plus minus 2 plus 40 minus 12 upon 2 square 5 square 25 29 plus 9 root 38 and root over 1 plus 65 plus 16 81. So, we can solve, simplify it. Here, 40 minus 16 means what? 24. So, 24 upon 9 into root 38. So, just simplify it, we can get 20 14 is minus, okay. So here 26. So this is our answer. Means solution, take modulus sign 9 root 38. So finally, theta equals to cos inverse 26 upon 9 root 38. So this is our angle between these two lines. Similarly, second question can be solved. Okay. Now, to question 12. Find the value of P so that the lines these are at right angles. Here we have to find the value of a constant value of P so you can solve it, just right angles means U1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 equals to 0. So you can write solution just how you can write solution. First of all, from the equation, find the value of A1, B1, C1, because right angle means for 12, right angle means A1, A2 plus B1, B2. B1, B2 plus C1, C2 equals to 0. Right angle means cos 90 is 0. So this is 0. So just put the value of B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, then you can get the value of P. Okay. Here, from question 12, 1 minus x. Just write 1 minus x, no? So question is given. 1 minus x, 7y minus 4. The first line is 1 minus x, 1 minus x, 7y minus 4, 7y minus 14, z minus 3 upon 3, 2p, 2. These are the, and another is what? 7 minus 7x upon 3p equals to, another line is given, just like y minus 1, 5 by 1, and another line, another point is z minus 6 minus z equal by 5. So these are given two lines, these are perpendicular. This is L1, this is L2. So L1 is perpendicular to L2, gives this. Here A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2 are made to find. 1 minus x, so you have to write as x minus 1. If we write x minus 1, there is minus common. So we can write it as x minus 1 upon minus 3. Taking minus common and take with 3. Because x minus something, y minus something, z minus something, you have to write. Here, what is given? 7y minus 14. That was just divide by 7. So y minus 2. By 2p by 7. It can be written like this. X minus y minus z minus 3. So z minus 3 upon 2. So this line can be written like this. So this is A1, this is B1, this is C1. Okay. It can be also written as how? 7 minus 7x. So take divide by 7 and take minus sign common. So what? X minus 1 upon minus 3p by 7. Because just multiply here 1 by 7 and 7 7 cancel and minus x minus 1 by 3p minus 1. 3p by 7 equals to here also y minus 5 by 1 is 1. Okay. Here z minus 6 by minus 5. So this is A2, B2, C2. Okay. Just put the value here, A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2, and you can get what? A1, E, these are the value. Minus 3 into what? Minus 3p by 7, minus 3p by 7 plus d1, this 2p by 7, 2p by 7 into b2, 1 plus c1, 2 into c2, minus 5. Minus 5 equals to 0. So just solve it. Okay, minus minus plus 9p plus 2p minus 70 equals to 0. 7 taking as LCM. So minus 10 minus 70 equals to 0. So from here 11p equals to 70. So p equals to 70 by 11. So value is what? 70 by 11. So this is the value of p. Clear? Right angle, that's why this is 0. Now 13, show that the line, these are perpendicular to each other. 13, in 13, they are given two lines and perpendicular to each other. Lines are perpendicular to each other if this condition will satisfy. So 13 can be also solved by using this, because perpendicular to each other means the sum of product of direction ratios should be equal to 0. So in question 13, we see that question 13 in question 13, first line is what? X minus 5 by 7, x minus 5 by 7 and y plus 2 by minus 5, y plus 2 by minus 5, z by 1. Another line, x, y, z, 1, 2, 3. X, y, z, 1, 2, 3. Very simple. L1 is this, L2 is this. Two lines are given. We have to show that they are perpendicular to each other. L1 is perpendicular to L2. If and only if what? A1 B1 plus A2 B2 plus C1, sorry, N plus N A2 B2 C2, N A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 equals to 0. Okay, so here A1, X minus X, Y minus Z minus 0, X, Y, Z. So this is A1, B1, C1, A2, B2, C2. Just we see that left hand side, A1, A1 what? 7 into 1 plus minus 5 into 2 plus 1 into 3. So this is equals to what? 7 minus 10 plus 3. So 10 minus 10 equals to 0, right hand side. So this is solved. Implies line 11 perpendicular to L2, 13. Okay, 14, find the shortest distance. Now the question is about shortest distance. So shortest distance you can find, you know, shortest distance can be found by using formula. Okay, here first in question 14, shortest distance between the line. So lines are given in the form of vector form. Okay, so vector form 14, what? First vector, first line 1 to 1, 14. L1, vector r equals to I plus 2j plus k plus lambda into 1 to 1 and I minus j plus k, I minus j plus k. This first line is given. Second line is given r equals to, in, it is also in vector form, 2i minus j minus k, 2i minus j minus k plus mu. Another vector is what? 2, 1, 2. 2i plus j plus 2k. These are two lines are given in vector form. Vector form, shortest distance we know. What is formula? Modulus of b1 cross b2 dot a2 minus a1 upon b1 cross b2 modulus. This is the formula in vector form. Just you have to calculate. First of all, b1 plus b2. This is b1, this a1. Compare it with the standard form. a1, a2. b1, b2. Clear? So here, b1 cross b2. Just you have to solve cross product. Find I, j, k. b1, b2. This is b1. This is b1 vector. This is b2 vector. So, I, j, k. b1, 1 minus 1, 1. 1 minus 1, 1. b2, 2, 1, 2. 2, 1, 2. Just solve it. Okay? What? I into this into this minus this into this. So, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. So, minus 2i j into this into this minus this into this. 2 minus 1 plus j. K into this into this minus this into this. Means 1 plus 2, 3. Plus 3k. Okay? Plus 3k. So, b1 plus b2. I minus 3, no, minus 3i plus 3k. So here, b1 cross b2 equals to two minus two is here. So 2, 1, 2. So here minus 2, minus 3, minus 3, and j 2 minus 2, 0, j, and k 1 plus 2, 3, 3k. Okay. Minus 3i plus 3k. This is this. And also modulus. So b1 cross b2 equals to this. And b1 cross b2 equals to what? Minus 3a square plus 3a square equals to 3 root 2. Because 3 square, 3 square, 2, 3 square, 3 root 2. Okay. So 3 root 2. This is b1 plus b2 modulus and vector is this. And a2 minus a1. A2 minus a1 means this is a2. And this is a1. So a2 minus a1. This minus this. So we can write here value. B1 plus b2 minus 3i plus 3k dot. A2 minus a1. This minus this. 2i minus i. I. Minus j minus 2j. Minus 3j. Minus k minus k. Minus 2k, this, upon modulus, modulus, 3 root 2. So, this is equals to what? Now, dot product, this into this. So, I into I means minus 3, j, j not nothing, so 0, k minus 6 upon 3 root 2. So, minus 9 upon 3 root 2. So what? 3 minus, minus 3 by 2, minus 3 by root 2. So this is equals to 3 by root 2. We have to take positive sign. So shortest distance is 3 by root 2. Shortest distance is 3 by root 2. 3 by root 2. Okay, so you can write it 3 by root 2 means 3 by root 2 into root 2 by root 2. So 3 root 2 by 2. This is solder distance between two lines. Okay, this is our answer. 3 root 2 by 2. Clear? Similarly, 15 can be solved. Find solder distance. Here Cartesian form are given. Cartesian form are given. Okay. So 15 can be also solved. Just use formula and solve it. 15. Clear? Just use the value here. Here lines are given just like x plus 1, y plus 1, z plus 1. 15. X plus 1, y plus 1, z plus 1 upon what are given? 7 minus 6, 1. 7 minus 6, 1. This first line and second line is what? X minus 3, y minus 5, z minus 7. X minus 3, y minus 5, z minus 7 upon 1 minus 2, 1. 1 minus 2, 1. These are given. Clear? Now, we have to find shortage distance. So, we know shortage distance is equal to what? This upon the formula of shortage distance in Cartesian form, just we know how can we write this x2 minus x1, y2 minus y1, z2 minus z1, okay, here a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, here sum of a1, b2 minus a2, b1 square 3 times a1, b1, cn, a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, x2, here point will be what? X plus 1, so x minus minus 1. So here we can write x minus of minus 1 upon 7, because x minus x1, so here x1 is what? Minus 1. So here also we can write minus 1 minus 1, that is a1, that is x1 equals to minus 1, y1 equals to minus 1, z1 equals to also minus 1. Here x2, x2 equals to, x2 equals to 3, y2 equals to 5, z2 equals to 7, and this is a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2. Just put value here. You know this means what? 3 times sum. A1, b1 minus a2, b2 plus b1, c2 minus b2, c1 hello square plus c1, c2 minus c2, c1 c2, a1 square. Sum of this. So just find and put the answer. Okay. So 15 can be also find by using formula. And you can get the answer as 2 root 9, root 29. 2 root 29. Solve it. Okay. Putting your value. This means just as we have to write 2 times sum. AB, BC, CA. 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, minus, minus. Just put all the value, a1, b1, c1, a2, b2, c2, x1, y, z1, x2, y2, z2. Put here and solve this determinant and also solve this and take modulus sign to root 29, you can get the answer. So, remaining two questions you can also solve, 16 and 17. Shortest distance between the lines whose vector equations are given like this. Same questions, just use as 14. Find the shortest distance between the lines whose vector equations are also given, 17. Here, just a constant, just lambda, mu, they are given in each term. just you have to collect that 17, just you have to write like this. For 17, you have to like this, r equals to something plus t into something. Just write in this form, that is t is the constant, lambda, just like here also s is another equation, this into s into this, just write like this, t and s are constant. So then this is a1, this is a2, this is b1, this is b2 for 17 questions. So solve all these questions in your copy and send me some solution of some questions for your attendance. Okay.